Sorry, guys, I got cut off on the last one. So, picking up after eggs, flavoring, seasons and flavorings add a variety to baked products. Flavorings change the texture and color of baked goods as well as their flavor. Recipes often include spices and liquid extracts such as maple, almond, or vanilla. Some recipes call for dried fruit, chopped nuts, citrus peel, flavored syrups, or chocolate. So, with baked goods, there's two types of consistencies you can have, either a dough or a batter. What do you think the difference between a dough and a batter is? Batters have more liquid and less flour than doughs. Think of pancake batter. And doughs have less liquid and more flour than batters, like cookies. Pour batters are thin and made from nearly equal amounts of liquid and flour, cakes, pancakes, and waffles. Drop batters have thicker mixtures that contain twice as much flour as liquid, and they are usually dropped by the spoonful onto baking pans, like quick breads or cookies. Soft doughs have a ratio of one part liquid to three parts flour and is sticky but moldable. Yeast breads and rolled biscuits are examples. Stiff doughs have a ratio of one part liquid to 6 to 8 parts flour, and it's the easiest to handle. These are pie crusts and some rolled cookies. So that finishes up baking basics, and I'll post this recording and the other one along with your assignment in Google Classroom.